just win and hope Turkmenistan lose. That's it.
And then we get bronze.
All right, folks, good afternoon to you and welcome to the Grand West Ice Rink. It's the final day. I can't believe we've reached this point. We've reached the final day of the 2023 IIHF Ice Hockey World Championships Division 3 Group A matches out in Cape Town in South Africa. I say good afternoon to you, of course, because it is 2 p.m. local time, or just a couple of minutes away from 2 p.m. local time. Wherever you are in the world, good morning, good evening, good night, whatever it is, in the commentary position alongside Nadine Sheffield, as I have been all week long. Nadine, a couple of very important games. People always think, all of the various medal positions have been locked up. That is not the case here. And in fact, what I'd like to do is just very quickly. Oh, here come our officials onto the ice, and we'll talk about them in a short while. What I'd like to do, though, is just quickly recap the results from Friday for you in the action we saw on Friday. So, our first game on Friday saw this result. Very impressive performance there from Chinese Taipei as they got the better of Luxembourg. Both teams in action today, obviously just not against each other. 10-0 there. Let's see the other results from Friday. Where it was South Africa in action against Thailand. Wow, what high skill, high quality, but disappointing ultimately for the local fans as Thailand come away with a 5-2 result and a win there. What it means is that our standings look a little bit like this now. There we go. Those are the standings, and so you look at it on the face value and go, oh well, Chinese Taipei have locked up the gold medal, and it's going to be between Thailand and Turkmenistan for the silver. Let me tell you, you are going to need a degree in astrophysics. You are going to need advanced mathematics, because this tournament is not over yet. None of the medal positions are locked down yet. There are still opportunities for other teams to come away with gold, silver, bronze.
Yeah.
Nadine Sheffield.
Yeah, it's very complicated. We have our results manager working through all the different scenarios, trying to get it in our heads how it's all going to work out, and it's quite complicated. But as far as I'm aware, if Turkmenistan win this, they get gold.
But yes, if Turkmenistan win this, they will get gold. That's the first thing I can tell you. So they've got a lot on their plate in terms of what is on the table for them. Chinese Taipei have been, in my mind, the most impressive team at this tournament.
Yeah.
Brilliant ice hockey. And so Turkmenistan are going to have to pull one out the bag to beat a team that is performing like they are.
Yeah.
But still, stranger things have happened in sports. Stranger things have happened in ice hockey. That may very well happen.
Oh,
good timing. Gives us more opportunity to talk a little bit more whilst we have... a bit of time. There was a power outage here. That'll get corrected very, very shortly, of course, and get us underway.
Yeah, so if you're wondering why we have a blackout, it's due to the fact that South Africa obviously doesn't have enough power going around. So we have to share it. And right now we are coming back off of generators and we're going on to
mains. Let's have a look at the team sheets, though. Of course, that's coming up in a short while. And important... for us to just make note of some of the key players inside both of these teams. There we go. Those are the teams. There we go. Chinese Taipei also really good performances here from these players. Certainly expecting some really good results there as well. So and good performances.
I can't reach behind me.
Oh, what's behind
me?
To
get your list.
There we go. Everything is good in the world. Do want to make mention of the officials because they're already on the ice. We just didn't have the names in front of us. Andrea Benvignu from Italy is the referee for tonight. There's Miroslav Lotsky from the Czech Republic as the one lines person, and Oscar Perez from Mexico. Had a really good evening last night with a lot of the people involved in the tournament, and great to spend time with the officials.
And the goalies that are in at the moment for Chinese Taipei, we have Fu Sang Kui, number 25. And we have Raman Miradov, number 1 for Turkmenistan. And there we go. And it has started.
That's an interesting decision from Chinese Taipei to put their number 25. Did you say it's the number 25 in the goals?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Which is interesting because I've got to tell you that Cao has been just bizarrely good. Here we go. Turkmenistan, though, getting their first shot on goal, looking for a way through and a positive start, because for Turkmenistan, it's a simple equation. Win, and we take home the gold. I mean, it is that simple. As Chinese Taipei come up the ice, and in come the shot. Snatched out of the sky there by Rahman Miradov. Now, so no disrespect to Kuwait. I would have just thought they would have gone with, for me, what their number one keeper is. Yeah. But I mean, so be it.
But you see, it also depends on how their practice went this morning and also how their warm-up is. They make these decisions on who's looking better, who's more comfortable. And, you know, it all depends on the day.
Obviously it does, but maybe he's carrying an injury.
Could be.
Because he has been just fantastic performed really well in the first two or three games, and then was not seen from again. Here come Chinese Taipei, really good skill. This is the one thing about this team. They find each other, pull the trigger. Lots of opportunities.
And again, it's like you watch the difference between the teams and the precision passing and the decisions and knowing where their players are, and Chinese Taipei have that. So it's always nice to watch that kind of hockey.
Now, this is a very experienced, very comfortable team. They know each other. They know, you know, where they are on the ice. It's almost instinctive at sometimes. As Chinese Taipei.
Oh, saying it touched out of bounds.
Look, I've got to tell you that Turkmenistan certainly reinvented and revived their position. They had a really good start against South Africa at the beginning of the tournament, and then went down 9-6, and you would have been forgiven for writing them off, but they came back strongly. They did what they needed to do, and that was to win their next games, and that is why they are in this position. Here comes the shot. Oh, a little bit off target, nobody there to deflect it in, so it definitely was miscued.
Turkmenistan are putting on an impressive show right now. They are attacking well, and they're managing to keep possession right now down in the attacking zone. Big shot there, but deflected off of number 8. And we've got a player down. I didn't quite see, but that's going to be an interference call on Chinese Taipei number 4, it looks like.
Chinese Taipei were gone for all money. I'm keen to see this one, how it is that he was obstructed.
So that's Chow In Sang, number 4, going in the penalty box for 2 minutes in interference. Late hit, I would presume.
Okay, it was Geldemiradov, Aslan Geldemiradov, who's just getting his wind back.
Nice new shot there of the guys in the penalty box.
I'm loving this camera angle on the lads who go do a little bit of time in the sin bin.
It's nice to see whether they're smiling or very angry. See if they're upset with the call or if it's okay
or
not.
Doesn't seem to be upset. It's
no,
like,
it's all smiles.
Anyway, here we go. Got to tell you that I think that, I speak under correction, the Chinese Taipei team are the only team, maybe bar South Africa, I'm not sure, to have scored on their power play in this tournament. I'm just trying to recall.
I actually wouldn't be able to tell you unless I actually looked at the sheets. I can go try and look. Hang on a sec.
I wanted to show you Nadine Sheffield the replay on the hit. Here it comes. You can see the number 10 getting himself.
Oh, from behind even. That's a bit silly.
Okay. That was always going to go to the sin bin.
It wasn't too hard, but it was definitely uncalled for from behind in the slot, and it looked like a cross check. Could have been either of them calls, you know.
Turkmenistan looking for a good position. They're launching an attack. They're being very composed. Intercepted, though, by Chinese Taipei. Dumped down the ice. It won't go for icing, obviously, because we're in a power play. Good passing. Precise. Finding each other. This is what makes both of these teams so dangerous. Looking for the wraparound. Not to be shuttled down the ice.
So Chinese Taipei have scored a lot. In the first game they played, they scored a lot of power play goals. I'm not going to say how many because I'm just looking at quickly, but they've scored on the power play. I'm going to the next game for you.
You can see the build-up here from Turkmenistan. Shot comes in. It's loose. And it's
still loose.
Still loose, but able to be kept out there.
Turkmenistan have scored on a power play.
Off the body. Oh, that hurt. Number 15 got nailed on the knee. It was Pan. It was just the way it goes. The shot came straight into his knee. And he's going to limp a little bit for a ball as the shot goes across the face of ball. All of the pressure coming from Turkmenistan early on. Of course, it is a power play, so it makes sense that they'll be able to apply that as Chinese Taipei clear their lines. About 6 or 7 seconds left on this one. It's going to come to nothing, unfortunately, for Turkmenistan.
So far, Taipei, South Africa, and Turkmenistan have all scored on their power play. Luxembourg as well. So all the teams have scored on their power play.
Yeah, what I was interested to find out, and I don't know if that stat exists, Nadine, is the teams that score, you know, when the power play is against them.
Penalty kill, shorthanded.
When they are shorthanded, they're sort of four players or three players, whatever it is, and they still score. That's an interesting stat, I think.
There is that stat, and I have to hunt for it.
The things that you get from me is amazing, you know?
Well, stats are amazing.
Tickets,
things.
Jerseys, pins, and
coffee. And beer. You got me tequila.
Yeah. I paid my debts last night. Well, not all of them, just two. I just paid two debts last night. Just for those of you going, is that man ever going to pay his fines? And I did. Paid two of my fines.
You still owe me eight from the woman's.
Goodness. She's got a memory like I don't know what those things are that have good memories. Here we go. Turkmenistan. Good initial intent and pressure as they come up the ice. Looking for a way through. Shot comes in. A really good one. Skidded low and just not able to be on target. Intercepted. It's anybody's game at this stage. I've got to tell you, 14 minutes that remain in this first period, as it's mostly been really good really good performance from Turkmenistan. As I say that, Chinese Taipei almost scored the goal. Is that a call for a penalty? Yes, it is. He's pointing at the other linesman, but I'm sure it can't be him. Chinese Taipei, I've got to tell
another
you, this
one.
Is probably the most I've seen them go into
slashing.
The sin bin for...
slashing this one. Number it's 13. Lin. Specifically number 13, it's Yo Chen Lin for slashing.
Another opportunity now for Turkmenistan. We saw them very strong in that last power play, not able to convert it, unfortunately, but certainly they had the advantage, they had the edge, they had the opportunities. So they look for a wraparound. Quick pass, looking to find a player to present themselves, and here comes the shot, the rebound, and it's just again intercepted there by Turkmenistan. Back with the Chinese Taipei, they're looking for the pass, not able to control it as it runs up the ice. It's still Chinese Taipei, short-handed as they are. I don't know that anybody's told them that they're short-handed, because they are just applying pressure. Here we go. Turkmenistan fast, quick up the ice. Gubanov looking for a way through. Shot to come, but just at the crucial moment, just before he pulled the trigger. Here it comes. Skids loose. Two players basically sliding into the boards, lying on top of each other. That's, can't be comfortable. And in it comes. Great keeping. Kui is doing such a good job. Looking for a way through. Fakes the shot. Great effort there, but just goes wide. Lots of pressure. Turkmenistan understand that opportunities like this against a team like this, you've got to take them. and they will start to get a little bit frantic. In fact, this is probably them being frantic at the moment. Good passing, good interplay, and not able to get the shot. Looking now for the layoff. Still, it's Turkmenistan. Here comes the trigger man. There's the shot. Bounces loose. Still 20-odd seconds left on the power play. Snapshot. Great effort. But kept on. Looking for the wraparound. Not to be. Turkmenistan unbelievably still hold on to it. They're running out of time on this power play. And they've certainly once again taken full advantage of it. That's an offside call there from the one lines person. And I've got to tell you, spot on.
Sorry, I am concentrating on trying to find your stats for you.
Yeah.
We know what you're doing. Each game.
We know what you're doing. Because that's an interesting stat. It'll show you, in terms of the teams in this tournament, who are the ones who can weather the storm best and come away with the strike. There we go. Well, that's the end of the power play. 5-on-5 now as Lynn gets back into the action. It's 12 minutes left on the first period. I still got to tell you, for the 8 minutes that we've seen thus far, really good showing from Turkmenistan. They've put, for me, the favoured team on the back foot, who now come up the ice. Taipei with a shot. I love the way Meridov catches the puck and then looks around as if to go, I didn't catch the puck. I don't know where it is, Rev.
Shit.
Here we go, let's have a look at this. A bullet, absolute tracer bullet, and he's got it, and now he's looking. Where is it? I don't know where it is, guys. Oh, here it is in my hand. Okay, that's what he's saying.
Yeah, he makes it interesting.
Here we go, it's Turkmenistan. I like their green kit, really nice. They're up the ice against the blue and white of Chinese Taipei.
Jeremy, who did you say scored a shorthanded goal?
I thought it was Chinese Taipei.
I think it's Turkmenistan here. No. Yes. No. No.
Okay. See, she does that from time to time. She talks to herself. She will ask a question and then have the answer. I've gotten used to this over time. We've been together for quite a few years. So this is, I'm used to it. You may very well be tuning in for the very first time, in which case...
yeah, I'm very not
take some getting used to. Hold on, what's going on here? What did I do to this computer?
I don't know what you did. Why?
Can you fix it? Could you use the computer person?
But it's working, isn't it?
Oh. There it is.
Well, now you've done it.
Now I've done it. Here we go. Lots of...
I am not seeing a shorthanded goal. But I know there was one, but I don't remember who.
Can I ask you, is that really the number 25 in the Chinese Taipei goal?
Yes.
How sure are you? How much money can you put on the table now?
The fact that it was on my score sheet, and that's what's on the line, like here, on the stat sheet.
And on his jersey?
Well, if the stat sheet's wrong, then I'll find out. But I can't. It does look like it does have a number one on it, doesn't it?
Does it? I mean, I'm just looking. I'm sorry. I'm asking cryptic questions.
It's a good
but
question.
I can't see it.
Question.
It is definitely.
No, it isn't. They've got it wrong on the.
It's
sheet.
Definitely number one, guys. Poyu Tsao is well. At least the jersey number is number one.
Their lineup start was wrong on the stats. So.
So that's interesting. Scratch everything I said about the fact that they should have started with Sao because it looks like they have. Kui did see game time in, I think it was the previous game, but I think that we've got Sao back in the goalposts. The information we were given was that it was number 25 Kui who was in the goalpost, but we were a little bit confused by that ourselves. Anyway, back
I
to the
will
action.
Investigate that. I'm not finding a shorthanded goal.
Almost, I'm almost sure. Almost sure. And you know I'm good with these things. I'm like an elephant. I remember things. I mean, I don't even look like an elephant, but I remember things. Here we go. Here comes the chance. It's Chinese Taipei looking to get into action, but no way that they're going to clear that so easily. Turkmenistan certainly putting up all of the blocks. Flops it in there like one of those really, really little tricky little shot there from number six, Shen, for Chinese Taipei. It's fresh legs from Chinese Taipei. In fact, both teams, as we get ourselves ready for this face-off, it's deep inside the red zone of Turkmenistan, who have asked all the questions. Chinese Taipei have had all the answers. Now the shoe's on the other foot. Let's see what we've got now. Brandon Tsai, of course, making himself very visible on our message board. Good to see you, Brandon. Thanks very much for your messages. And then people cheering for Turkmenistan as well. I'm not too surprised. It is an international feed. By all means, if you've got a favorite in any of the teams, give them a shout out. Tell us who it is that you're supporting. And we will try our very best to get to all of that. Let's see. Cleared by Turkmenistan. It's a rebuild for Chinese Taipei with 8 minutes 48 seconds on the clock. Layoff, calm, composed,
it's
up the ice,
calm,
speed,
composed.
Skill, blocked. I mean, in one word, that is what happened there. Turkmenistan also knowing exactly what to do, stolen by Chinese Taipei. But all they could do was just sort of nudge it back down inside the Turkmenistan half of the ice.
Still a goalless game, and it's been already 12 minutes. It's quite interesting to see, because one would have thought, you know, Chinese Taipei would have.
Oh, that's a great effort there. Good performance.
So much
great
stronger.
Great pass. Not able to get it in.
Great save by Muradov. That went up and over.
That was an interesting one. Nicely done there. 22 of Chinese Taipei. Yang just getting in the way and making it very difficult and sneaking away the puck. Still with Turkmenistan as they look now with 7.5 minutes on the clock to find a way through. As Nadine is mentioning, it's unusual. Oh, stolen away. And
there they go, but a great,
great save there by Miradov. A little bit casual, if you ask me, from Chinese Taipei.
It's not their usual accuracy of... No, it's been a bit like I'm shooting at the goalie today. But here's my favorite. Wen just got on the line. Number 9 for Chinese Taipei. He is so fast, that guy, and his hands. Remember, I keep calling him a kid. He's all of 19 years old.
Wowzers, okay.
But he is so fast. And he's always in the right place, works hard. Good team player. Here we go, Chang. Big shot up high, just went over.
Miradov lost sight of it as it came towards him, went over his goal anyway, so no danger there. But it's still Chinese Taipei. You can see the shot counter suggesting that even though it's been a really good first performance by Turkmenistan, 13-6. 13-6 is, excuse my bigger pardon, 14-6 is what the shot counter says in favor of Chinese Taipei. It means nothing, though, in terms of the goals scored, because so far we've seen nothing. 6 minutes 45 to go, and they've corrected the initial...
starting keepers.
Starting keeper, which is now number one, Po Yu Tsao, who certainly, in my mind, is the number one keeper in this entire tournament.
It's either him or Klenische. I enjoy watching Klenische, Deadpool.
Yeah, he's good.
But mind you, yeah, it's tough because I also enjoy watching the Luxembourg keeper. I know he's not like... This poor guy's had a lot of goals scored against him. However, his style is so different to all the rest of them. Watching him do the splits so fast as well, it's quite boggling, I'm sure,
very
for many men.
Very athletic shot comes in. And
beautiful.
It's picked up on the half volley there, but now he realized he didn't have anybody to throw it out to. Okay, here we go. Almost 6 minutes flat left on the half, I beg your pardon, on the period, the first period of play. And it's Turkmenistan in position as it gets intercepted. Crucial interception, long range effort, great effort there as well from Turkmenistan. They've got to retreat because here come Chinese Taipei, dump up the ice by Yang. Now, one back by Turkmenistan. Just so much hassling and hustling. Shot comes in. It bubbles free. Really thought that There was an opportunity there for Chinese Taipei. There probably was. But the upshot of it is a face-off. Let's have a look at that one. You can see comes up and it bobbles free. Not able to get hold of it, but eventually almost hits the puck under the glove of Miradov. We'll go, thank goodness.
And the other guy behind him is like jumping in the space to try and stop anything coming out. Good teamwork there.
It feels quiet.
A tripping, but not seen by the referee. Number 22 to 21. Up to 24.
Shot Lynn comes in. Just nudged away. Fingertip save there from Miradov. Again.
It almost looked like he didn't see that one coming. But it was behind anyway.
Here we go. It's Turkmenistan looking to rebuild. A bit of a nasty hospital pass to his player, but still comes away with it.
Here we go.
Stolen.
Turnover. Chinese Taipei taking it up wide.
Looking for an opportunity. Not too sure what that was, but...
It's strange that they're taking these random shots, because usually they're much more set up in the attack.
Much more precise.
They usually have like one exactly charging that net, like straight away.
That's what I'm going... The performance so far from Chinese Taipei, by the way, who almost coughed up a goal there, is a little bit lackluster, a little bit tired, and certainly not as precise as we've seen in recent games. This is not the game for them to drift, for them to lose focus, because if they get on the wrong end of this result, there we go, wave goodbye to the gold medal. Shot comes in. Great effort there, wraparound, but not to be for Turkmenistan. Got to tell you, that was a brilliant opportunity. Love to see that one again, as a couple of fresh legs get onto the ice. It's like peak hour traffic. Here we go.
Again, a shot from such a wide angle and no one in there for a rebound, but of course not given a rebound, Miradov.
Yeah, Miradov, I don't even know how he caught that. Okay, let's have a look at this. This is the shot from earlier. You'll see number 17 coming in. Opportunity and almost kills our cameraman. But...
Just went over.
Just went over. Great instinctive. Wasn't going to wait. First time shot and just not able to get it through. Turkmenistan away with it now. Oh, intercepted. Chinese Taipei looking to set themselves up. As I said, their composure, that's not that they rattled, but they just haven't been as precise as we've seen before. They are making interesting decisions in terms of when to shoot, and they don't seem to be really driving and taking time with the shot. So, I mean, let's just see. We've got some time left on this one. 3 minutes as the shot comes in.
Big shot, and it was
massive
almost screened.
Big effort there from Turkmenistan, not able to score.
They're getting good opportunities. You know, their shots have all been accurate, most of them as well. So it's good. They're putting a good fight up against Chinese Taipei. Playing a lot better. But, I mean, that's what you expect at the end of the tournament, to have your feet firmly on the ground and, you know, used to all the players so you can get out there and do what you need to do. You should have known now by now how the tactics are of the opposite team. Adjust to it. So we'll see if it turns out. I mean, there's 2.5 minutes left. It's still 0-0.
Fabinus, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly, says good game so far. So thanks very much. Send the messages through, folks. I'd love to hear from you. As with 2.5 minutes on the clock, we have ourselves a face-off deep inside the red zone of Turkmenistan. They will not want to leak anything. Shot comes in and save jumping almost off the shoulder of Miradov, but nonetheless, a save is a save. Miradov can put some deep heat on that a little bit later. Here we go. It's Chinese Taipei. I think that they very well may have to endure one or two words from their coach at the break after the first period, because I've not seen them this lackluster, this off the pace in the entire tournament.
Seen it either. But maybe it's just because Turkmenistan are really playing a good game
today.
Well,
exactly. But I think that they're also allowing... I think that Chinese Taipei are allowing Turkmenistan to play the way that they're playing. They just don't seem to be upping their effort, their game shape at the moment. So let's see. I mean, 16-7 in terms of the shot count, it does suggest that the effort is coming from Chinese Taipei. But that is only half the story. it's the shot comes off the skates of the Chinese Taipei player. They are still looking for a way through. And as I said, they will start to have the feeling that, wait a minute, we should be playing a little bit better, a little bit faster, more precise, and we should have at least one goal. That isn't the case.
I must tell you, Jeremy, I've searched through every single game sheet, all the stat sheets. Is a penalty coming now? That looked a bit painful, Shane.
Yeah.
He's getting a hooking call.
Yeah, and that definitely was a hooking call. Let's have a look at this one, Nadine. You know your official, put your official's hat on.
You should know these things.
I know, but I'm just saying, I'm not the...
Who's going in number 8? It's definitely a hook.
Hooking, yes.
But I would like to see the replay, Shane. He looks sore. He went into the board really hard after he fell.
He did, yeah.
Shane.
And it was clear as day. And here we go. Just take a look at this one. In comes the pass, and all over him like a cheap suit. And thud into the his back.
Where
into the
board. Come up with these sayings, Jeremy. My word. At least he's up. I'm glad he's up. Hopefully you'll be okay. Get back on shortly.
You might have to borrow some of the deep heat from Miridov, but nonetheless.
Listen, as I was saying,
there was no shorthanded.
No shorthanded goals. I've gone through every single one, and I could have sworn there was one, but I haven't found it.
I feel like there was, because I think I still mentioned that. I said, "Wow, they scored on
shorthanded.
On a shorthanded goal. Wow, that one rebounded 5 rows back into the stands. I think you should hold him to the puck." I mean,
it's the Nadine. Second last game, so yeah, maybe, you know, but Ralph won't let it happen.
Nadine Sheffield will have been up in the stands so fast, demanding that puck back.
No, I'm not.
Chance, in it comes. That's another one that's gone out of bounds. I think the youngster's holding onto the puck. Here we go, looking for a way through.
Big shot.
Comes in massive into wow. The chest. Otsao, no problems. He will catch that all day long.
Yeah, no, I definitely can't find a single shorthanded goal.
Here we go. It's a nice pass. Lots of time, lots of space. Bullet. And thanks very much. I'll just keep it right here in my armpit. What Sao had to say about that one. 45 seconds and a split second after that.
Split second.
Here we go. Looking for a way through and looking for the wraparound, but... Gonna have to lay it off to hide it off. Chinese Taipei up the ice, 30 seconds, 21 seconds, I beg your pardon, and shot comes in.
Up and out of bounds.
Uses his elbow. Does Miridov to spare the blushes of his defenseman?
No, sorry, Jeremy, there's definitely none recorded as shorthanded goals.
Okay.
I think either we went mad or the stats are incorrect. Wait, I found it.
Here we go. I knew I wasn't losing.
Karlsa scored it. South Africa, shorthanded goal. That's the only one.
I told you it was South Africa.
I'm sorry.
I did think it was also Chinese Taipei. But
I also thought so, but it's not. Not the case that I can see in any of their games.
Shot comes in. Oh, it doesn't. It's a bit of a full shot and... Great effort, good position there. Chang, you can see this one, trying to get away from the Turkmenistan player. And as he turns his back on him, it looks like he is just axed from behind. I'm sure that isn't the name of the offense.
You know, axed. That's there is such a thing as spearing, though.
Don't have the spearing either.
But if you chop down a tree, then you're really slashing more than any.
Have a look at this. Turns away from him.
Ooh.
And then plants him.
Ouch. Well, he's getting that for hooking. Oh, wait. Oh, my stats haven't updated. See, I'm so busy with your stats trying to figure it out. Okay, so that's Arslan Nurev going in for number 16 for tripping.
And also, of course, we saw hooking from number 6 for Chinese Taipei. He was in there for one again.
Okay, so I've also had confirmation from our results manager. We, South Africa, are the only ones that have scored. a shorthanded goal. And it was by Carlson.
I was beginning to think I was living in an alternative reality, but not so much in this particular instance. Okay, so there we go. We've got the break between the first and the second period. About to get ourselves into the...
He's got the puck.
You've got the puck, young man.
We have the guy who has the puck.
If I were you, come over here.
Come over here.
What's your name?
Yoandre.
Come a little bit closer. What do you say
your name
is?
You're on TV.
Yoandre. I'm going to have to speak English to you because the people that are watching us don't speak Afrikaans. It's okay. Now, that is an official World Championship puck. Okay. But I want you to put it in your pocket and take it home with you. Okay, will you do that?
Just if anybody asks, you say Jeremy said
if
it's
okay. If
anybody
wants to know, then you do that. Give me a high five, pal. There we go. There we go. Oh, I like it.
Shame.
I finally got it right. When the puck goes into the crowd, let them take it away. Nadine, I just want to quickly wrap up what we saw in the first period.
Yeah.
Nadine was doing a lot of number crunching, and we were right. There was a shorthanded goal scored. Only one was scored by Team South Africa. It was...
Carlson
who scored. I tell you what, I don't mind how many goals South Africa scores, shorthanded or not, today. Certainly just hoping that they score as much as they possibly can. No goals at all scored in this first period, which I've got to tell you, I'm a little bit surprised by. The shot counter suggests a very strong performance from Chinese Taipei. I can tell you, it was anything but that. This is not their usual performance. This is not how we've seen them play through the tournament. I'm fairly sure that in the nicest possible way, Coach Tong Weng is going to say to them that they're going to need to lift their game
and
come back
so
with
too.
A better, with more intensity in the second period. Just your thoughts?
Yeah, no, I definitely agree because I think that, you know, I don't know how much they realize that if they do lose this, they can lose gold. And I think that's definitely not what they want to do, especially after the performance that they've just had throughout this tournament. It's been beautiful. So I'm thinking coach is going to go and give them a bit of a, hey guys, what the hell? It's the last day. Why are you on holiday? It's not holiday. It's time to play and it's time to get gold.
Exactly.
But I think the same thing could be happening in Turkmenistan's change room right now because they are doing very well.
They're doing very well. Look, I mean, I think that Turkmenistan understand what's at stake here. Not to say the Chinese Taipei don't, but Turkmenistan understand what's at stake. They know that a win, even if it's 1-0, whatever it is, any win is good enough for gold medal. And so for the next two periods of play, they will put their bodies on the line. They don't care how many bruises they come off this ice with. We've already seen Miridov saving with his chest, with his elbow, with his shoulder. Whatever it takes, he will make sure that nothing gets past him. And it'll be worth it if they pack a gold medal into their suitcase.
Yeah, I think so for sure. I'm looking forward to seeing the next period. I'm sure you guys all are. Let me send a quick shout out to all of our sponsors for this tournament that have made this possible for us. The third World Championship in South Africa in 1 year. The first country to ever do this, ever, in the whole history of IIHF. So well done to Cape Town and the LOC. But the sponsors that help make this possible is the City of Cape Town, Factor 6, CFW Fans, Sun Grand West, DigiCape, Aquila, SASCOC, the train station, Bloberg Meat, Western Cape Government, Ag Market, South African Ice Hockey Federation, Heart FM, Western Province Ice Hockey Association, Peninsula Beverages, Red Mountain, Pedigree Media, Sports Arts and Culture, Intro, Graphic Thought Design Company, Umgalelo Africa, CompuTicket, and IIHF. So we'll see you in about 10 minutes when there's going to be some highlights shown of the first period. See you just now.
All right, folks, welcome back. It's the start, or just about to be the start, of the second period of play, goalless out of the first period of play in what could very well be described as the gold medal match between Chinese Taipei and Turkmenistan. A win, effectively, Nadine Sheffield, for either of these teams gives them the gold medal.
Yeah.
So that's what's at stake. It's been an interesting first period because we've gotten ourselves used to a particular sort of level of play from Chinese Taipei in particular, and I don't believe we've seen it. I don't believe we've seen the Chinese Taipei play and shape that we've gotten used to. So somewhat disappointing, although to look at the shot counter, you'll go by Jeremy, 19-11.
Yeah.
Surely they've been driving play. Well, yes, that is one indicator, but I've got to tell you, very casual in some respects. Not as precise in other respects. That's what we've got at the moment. For the Turkmenistan players, I've got to tell you, I think that they fully grasp the opportunity here. They know that an upset win, which it really would be an upset win, for Turkmenistan, and they've got the gold medal, and we don't have to use the word upset again when we're around them, because they would certainly have richly deserved it. They really dominated the early stages of that first period, not so much as Chinese Taipei sort of got into it, flexed their muscles from time to time, but you know, they are giving as good as they get, our Turkmenistan. We've got an exciting 20 minutes about to get underway.
And it's 4-on-4 at the start of the period. There's going to be 49 seconds worth of penalty kill for Chinese Taipei. And then they will be on power play. So, let's see. Equal strength. We have Lin going down now. Well taken care of there by the defenseman from Turkmenistan.
I mean, this is going to be an obvious thing now for me to say, but it's quiet.
Mm.
And when South Africa play, it is just a bizarre. I mean, we are like we are at the front row of a rock concert when they are playing.
Awesome. Here's this replay. This last shot from above the circle. Just looked after there by Sal.
Not much longer for the Chinese Taipei. Six to be sitting. Lin just not able to collect the pass.
About to jump on now. There they go. So Chinese Taipei got a guy who just got on the ice. Now they've got two guys up at the top, cherry picking, waiting for the passes to come. Both waiting just on the top of the blue lines in the corners.
See that.
Interesting tactic.
Sneaky sneaks.
Now he's getting through. Now there's three at the top. And one goes through. Lin. Lin up to Chen. Chen looking for Sang. Sang to the other pointsman. I can't tell you who it is right now. Chen. Here it comes. Oh, just up in the air.
Looking for a deflection, a bit of a sneaky stick in there, not able to be, as Turkmenistan come away with it, stolen back by Chinese Taipei. 20 seconds left on the power play. Somebody's flattened over there on the Chinese Taipei side.
There they go. Lin in with it.
Not to be.
10 more seconds. Somebody lost their stick. Turkmenistan going in. Now they're equal strength, so we'll see how the changing of the tactics goes and systems they're going to play. Shen up over. I think he was just dumping it down so he could get some team changes. Turkmenistan with it. They're looking strong. They're looking eager. It's going to be a battle for who wants it in this game. They seem fairly equal today.
Yeah.
I don't know if Chinese Taipei is playing down or if... I think they might have dropped a little bit, but not too much. But I think Turkmenistan have definitely lifted their game.
Definitely. They certainly have. It's been a much improved performance from Turkmenistan. I was mentioning at the beginning of the game how they had started with so much promise against South Africa. 3-0 up very early in that first period of that game against South Africa, only for South Africa to come back at them and beat them 9-6. And I think that you would have been forgiven to think that, you know, Turkmenistan were going to become just one of the passenger teams of this tournament. But they certainly have done exactly what they needed to do, winning efficiently, really good play. And now here they sit in a position where they can take away the gold medal. All they need is one goal more than Chinese Taipei. In this game, they need to come away with the win here. Whatever that scoreline is, there's no aggregate or anything. It's just beat them by one goal or more, and the gold medal is yours.
Yeah, well, we'll see what happens. And I think it might all come down to the third period. But let's see. I mean, there's still lots left in this period. But at this rate, it could come down to the final period.
Matt Berg says that Taipei will show us great hockey this period. Well, there we go, Matt. That's a fair prediction. There we go. Atsal just nearing it away. His position in the goals is just amazing for me to see.
I see.
Now, here's an interesting thing.
Told him. It's quite interesting to see how many people are here today already. The stands are, you know, it's not full, but I mean, there's a lot more spectators today than there have been, being that it's a Sunday.
There's a buzz, and I think maybe a lot of them are yeah, as well, getting a good position in for the South Africa game as well.
Mm. Yeah, they don't want to lose out on good seats.
Ooh, just kneed away there by Miradov. Also good position and good performance there from him. He's done well throughout the tournament.
There's a sniper again. That guy sits here somewhere. We just don't know where. Up in the rafters somewhere. Picks on players.
Looking for a way through. Here comes number 19, Lynn.
Oh, just
no
missed
back there. Pass, but it's a little bit of a miscue, a bit of a fumble, and Turkmenistan have got a shot.
Turkmenistan getting it through the neutral zone. Isinov with it now. Isinov looking for it. Oh, tries to do a dangle. And then the other guy shoots through two people's legs. But still kept out by Sal from the point. They're passing it around nicely. Turkmenistan have definitely changed their system and they're doing very well. They've got more possession, more control, making more time for themselves. It's nice to see. They've improved a lot. But I've always said they're a very quick team as well.
They certainly are. They've done really well and I feel like they're in the stronger position. They're just putting really good efforts in on goal, just not able to convert any of them. Still though, Chinese Taipei.
Pressure's always on.
Looking for a breakaway, a win, because at the moment, I've got to tell you, the run of play very much from Turkmenistan's side. As they come away with it.
Oh, what a pass.
Looking for the pass shot to come.
Oh, what a save.
How many stickers flying, but saved there
and
by
again.
Sal.
Oh, it's
who
still
is
loose.
Flat on his back.
The puck is between his legs. It is still loose.
He's
but
he's lying on it.
It was just between his legs.
He is lying on it.
Wow. He was jumping all over like a jack-in-the-box, the poor guy, but he did some great saves there.
Yeah, exactly.
I hope to see that replay again. Wow. Here we go.
Here comes your replay. 21's got it. Shot comes in. Saved, or at least deflected away. Looking for more to come. Again, another shot.
And then
it comes back at him, and he goes there. It's between his legs.
And he has no idea where it is. And he's just like hoping it's under him. Wow. And we've got a number 14 for Turkmenistan coming in. And that is Serdar Kakayajonov, number 14, sitting in there. I'm not sure what it is that he went in for, but I'll tell you shortly. Two minutes for roughing, so that'll be for the tussle in front of the net.
A little bit harsh, I thought. I mean, this is ice hockey.
We just look like we're punching people.
Yeah, he didn't mean to. He said sorry. Must count for something.
No.
No. Okay. Anyway, all of these little rules that Nadine Sheffield keeps throwing at me.
Okay, we're back online. Good to know. Great save there by our Chinese Taipei goalie, Cao.
I've got to tell you, Cao is the business. He is the business. So difficult to score against him. So we look at the replay. You see the shot comes in and bobbles loose, but no problem there for Cao.
The chase is on. Offside.
Actually getting good at this. I saw that offside as well.
Oh. So you see, you can rave someday. We'll start you off slow.
Yeah, very slow.
It's one back into the Turkmenistan defensive zone. Big clearance there, but not getting through. High stick and call. Face off in the neutral zone. So Chinese Taipei are really needing to get a goal here on this power play to get on the board if they want to do anything with this. But Turkmenistan have been doing a very good job of penalty kills when they have had them. They're looking after these two cherry pickers, which is now the new power play tactic I see from Chinese Taipei. Number 9, the hard worker, when cleared away there by the defense. Dirk Money's done getting some fresh legs. Again, Chinese Taipei with a cherry picker.
I mean, so far it hasn't worked for them.
Lin.
But Lin now looking for a space, not able to get it. And it's these small little mistakes that just are so uncharacteristic for Chinese Taipei.
There's a lot of tussling going over there. That's 5 men on. Just parties and a stick.
Here we go, looking for a way through. Shot comes in. Not to be. Tell you what, as much as they apply pressure, Turkmenistan have been able to absorb it as well.
Where did it go?
It went into the Turkmenistan bench. I don't think he's going to be able to keep that puck. He may have to return it.
Yeah. Well, it looks like they have decided to keep it, whoever got it. That guy with the red, he got it. Now he's giving it to the guy in the green.
Here we go. It's Chinese Taipei. Great effort, but or great opportunity, but not able to convert.
Did you know that the World Championships now, every player up the top division, this is not here, the players all have GPS trackers on it, as well as the puck. So when you're seeing all the stats coming, you can actually see the stats in these little dots moving around on the on this like fake ice rink.
The puck.
The puck has a tracker in it.
You
GPS
are just
tracker.
Toying with my emotions
I'm
now.
I'm not. It's fantastic to watch. And you have a look at those, the way they've done the plays. You can see where every single player is on the ice when the goals are scored and where the puck goes. It's awesome. One day we will get there.
I'm not massively sort of thrown by the fact that the players with the GPS trackers, because a lot of the top teams do that. Shot comes in and saved there by Miridov. But the puck has got a tracker.
Yeah.
That is crazy. Let's have a look at the shot come in that we saw. Miridov just on a snaffle, no problem from his side. And what Miridov normally does is he catches those long-range efforts and then sort of looks around him, looks behind him as if to go, I don't have it, where is it? That's what he does normally. Bit of a miscue as Turkmenistan come away. Another uncharacteristic error from Chinese Taipei.
Oh, up over out of bounds, and it's out the goal, outside the eyes again. Is that guy going to keep it?
That went almost into the bar area.
Well, there's another person with a puck.
There we go.
Oh, he's going to give it to Simon.
Simon's
going
to get the puck. Here we go. Well done, Simon. An official.
And he's
going through pucks in this game.
Right? He's going to keep it.
I would keep it.
Yeah, we know you, Jeremy. You know, we still have a whole other game to play. We need kind of pucks to get through.
These guys will stop hitting it into the crowd. It's a great memento for the fans, I think.
Jason was giving away $200 the one tournament. If you brought him a puck, he'd give you 200 grand.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It was a good incentive to get them back.
Wow, that was... No, hold on a second. I've got to see that
tripping
one again.
Is that Wayne?
Look at this one. It was fancy tap dancing. I don't know what
this is. He doesn't have a stick.
He's got no stick, right? So he sees the player coming and watch this.
Oh,
he tries to kick
he
it.
He didn't. He fell all on his own. The guy didn't even trip him. His stick wasn't even near him. Shame.
That is just a really poor call.
Number 11 getting that tripping call.
Jen's going, I didn't do a thing. I didn't even touch him.
Quentin Jen.
I mean, I barely looked at him.
Wrong place, wrong time.
Exactly.
Too close to the view, and the referee doesn't get to see our nice slow replay.
And, of course, wrong place, wrong time. Then, right place, right time, maybe now for Turkmenistan. Good opportunity. They have the power play. Shot. Shot comes in. Setting it up. Trigger man. And almost. So I'll tell you what. You're going to have to wake up early in the morning to get past him. There we go. Yuval Levi is asking how they get to wear such high numbers.
And again, I still haven't found out yet, and I've been asking the question daily, and I haven't gotten any answers. So I've asked my results manager once again to see if he can find out.
Miscued effort. Here comes that gaping hole next to the keeper was there, but not able to take advantage of it. Let me tell you now, I've got jersey number 55, so I'm hoping that it's a proper rule.
Our double IHF also, results manager, also says he doesn't know. So it's a question that I cannot, unfortunately, answer for you.
I mean, is it a rule that you can't have more than 25? I mean, higher than 25?
It used to be a rule.
Okay. Clearly, it's not anymore.
And I have no idea why, but yeah, it's the first time I've ever seen, and it's only one team that's got the high numbers. And that is Thailand that's got them, eh? Yeah. Thailand with the high numbers.
So they know something we don't.
Mm-hmm. I don't think so.
Did Nadine say, oh, no, she definitely didn't.
I would have known.
Yeah, I would have known too.
I think Jeremy's eyes would have lit up.
That is a double tequila down for her if she had. Let me tell you now. Just for those of you who are keeping score, I did pay my fines last night for this tournament.
Not all of them.
Not all of them. How many do you guys still owe?
Too many.
Oh,
I'll be too drunk to have paid them all.
Pressure from Turkmenistan. It feels like the dam wall has got to break. But it's just not doing it. I mean, the wall that belongs to that dam is owned by Po Yu Tsao. He is not going to let anything through for love or money.
No, he's doing a great job. So is the number one, Miradov, for Turkmenistan. I mean, he's had 19 shots.
Great effort, wow. Now, beautiful. Here's an interesting thing I've just noticed. By the way, 5-on-5 again as that power play comes to an end. Chen back on the ice.
Oh,
and
he's
into
got a
space.
Breakaway.
Great effort, and
in it is! From the penalty box to the top of the ice. Perfect pass. Breakaway.
That couldn't have been timed better if you tried it. Meredith's going, where on earth did he come from? Have a look at this one. There it goes. Runs. Oh, I beg your pardon. got it, and he is gone for all money and took his time.
Top shelf.
And got closer and closer to Mirdov, just making it impossible for him to react in time.
Sure.
What I was going to say was have a look at that shot counter. Before that particular goal, it was 19-17, and they came back from the first period break, and it was 19-11.
Yeah.
So they had shot nothing on goal, had Chinese Taipei, up to that point when they scored the goal. Interesting to see what happens now. All of Turkmenistan's plans have now gone in the wrong direction. What will they do? How will they bounce back? How will they react? As Chinese Taipei come away with it. That was split-second timing. And looking at another one.
Hey, two. Oh, hard work pays off.
It looks a little bit like there was a partial save and it just ran and rolled free.
So that first goal was scored by Quanting Chen, number 11. I'm not sure who scored this one, but it looks like number 9, Wen, got that one. But let's see.
Let's have a look at this.
It's number 6 with it. Wen going through the middle, crashing the net.
Gets
up
it
to number 13 and then to Wen. Wen gets
off
it.
Off the skates of number 2 for Turkmenistan. Inadvertent error there, just an unforced error. Tenayev just nudging it away in the direction that Mirdov was not going. And an opportunity to score.
So that was scored by...
There we go, here comes the penalty. Somebody's going to go to the naughty corner. Well, I'll tell you what, in no time, from goalless to Chinese Taipei, 2-0 up. There's still plenty of time left in this second period. There's an entire third period still to come, so the game not over yet. But you've got to believe with their noses in front, Chinese Taipei are going to be very difficult to get past now.
So that was a penalty now. I missed it.
Matt Berg says, told you guys, Taipei will show us great hockey. They are awesome. They certainly have been all tournament, Matt. It's just this... Oh, side netting. It's just this game that they've started so off-color. They've just been like skating around, no intensity, and then all of a sudden, bang, bang, we saw a double head tap there, and it was 2 goals.
How does his hair look so perfect? It just came out of a helmet.
I mean, where did you come with that comment? How does the man's hair look perfect?
Dude, he didn't have helmet head.
You see, these are the things we talk about. Not only the ice and the stats. We talk about the player's hairstyles. How does his hair, like an ad. How does his hair look so perfect? Nadine Sheffield sees everything, guys. I just wanted to know that.
I missed a lot of things.
She sees everything. There was one tournament where there was a guy with really long hair.
It was a New Zealand dude. It wasn't my favorite.
It was your favorite player.
I just couldn't believe how long his hair was.
He was
very number
long.
7, eh?
Oh, well, not that I remember.
Oh, come on.
Goodness gracious. We
no, you had your light for a couple of the ladies' ones. That's why. Uh-huh.
And shot to come.
Denied. And there's no a penalty. And it's going on number 10 for Chinese Taipei, it looks like. I don't know what yet. He hasn't quite given the call. Interference. So, to just let you know, the first goal was scored by Quan Ting Chen, number 11, and assisted by number 21, Ching Lin. Then the second goal was scored by Pei An Wen.
And can you tell what time, you know, what the time difference was between...
Sorry. There. Then the first assist was Yeo Chen Lin, number 13, and Yen Chen Shen with number 6 getting the second assist. And now we have Begench Dolomitrodov, number 17, going in for holding the stick. And then Yenlin Shen, number 10, going in for interference. So it's quite a lot of things that are
happening. Yes, I was going to say it was 33 seconds
between the goals.
Which is like a double tap that you just do not want to have at all. By the way, Dalian Röder says focus nades.
What am I focusing on?
You were talking about the man's hairstyle. And
you.
No, you.
You brought it up.
You said, how does he get such perfect
hair? Oh, that dude. There's another penalty coming. Ref's got his hand up. And it's going to be against Turkmenistan. So we have Chinese Taipei with an advantage. Goalie's off. So Turkmenistan can't score unless Chinese Taipei put it in themselves, of course.
All right.
And if you did, then yeah, you should be fired. So now it's 6-4.
Oh, and
sniper
chose that moment to sit down on his backside.
All right, so 21 is getting the penalty for high sticking.
Okay, here we go.
21 for Dumas. Take money stuff.
Wow. Here we go. Okay.
Can you say that name, please?
What did I say, man?
Number 21 going in there for the penalty. What's his name?
Beymaradov is in the in the sin bin.
Sorry, I'm trying to pull up the other stat sheets. I don't have
it. She's just full of stats today. I'll tell you, stats on everything.
Working hard.
I love it.
And we are waiting for the referee to have his conversation. But funnily enough, the referee is having a conversation without his linesman, which is not supposed to happen.
See,
as a linesman, you're supposed to go and have a chat
with everybody. Okay. Shot to come.
As a witness.
Oh.
Back your teammates. Here we go. Oh, by the way, thank you to the referees. Always thanking officials. Oh, come on, what about the head? Checking to the head there, ref.
See.
Bra.
And shot to come. 16.
And out of bounds.
And back on the ice.
Oh, there we go. Beymaret.
In and amongst all of that, we've got 3 minutes and 58 seconds left of the second period, and finally we've seen goals coming through. We were expecting position where Chinese Taipei would have the lead when the game started, but I've got to tell you, there were so many opportunities.
Ooh.
Oh, that sniper is just terrible. But I've got to tell you that it wasn't Turkmenistan, even though they really put the initial pressure on. In fact, it was Chinese Taipei who perfectly timed the exit of one of their players from the sin bin to be able to score the first goal.
Yeah.
33 seconds later, a bit of a deflection off one of the skates of the Turkmenistan players fell kindly for Chinese Taipei. Goal number 2, and they may very well ride this one out to take away the win and the gold medal. This will mean a lot to them at the end of the match if they're able to keep their noses in front. I'm going to tell you, Turkmenistan probably disappointed. The body language at the moment suggests that they are disappointed, but they've got plenty of time. They need to just take a deep breath and refocus and get themselves back into this game, because they certainly did have Chinese Taipei on the back foot for most of that first period.
Now they've got a penalty kill, but let's see. They've been managing pretty well. I see my sister is watching again. How's it, sis?
Back on the phone.
Yes. That's the only thing they have on the farm is satellite internet. There's no cell phone signal, nothing else. It's peace and quiet. Oh, and sheep.
Gotta love the sheep on the farm.
I miss her, I do. Anyway, great save there by the goalie, Muradov, keeping his team.
Good skill there from the Chinese Taipei player. Look at this wraparound effort.
Trying to backhand it, but Muradov sticks perfectly placed.
He's just not going to let him end it. By the way, why don't you sit down for a few seconds? Here comes the face-off. 3 minutes exactly on the clock, and blocked. And shot in, and runs free.
And it's luckily held on to.
Good glove save there.
He's
telling the Turkmenistan players, he's the Chinese Taipei number. Is it number 8? Let's just double-check my numbers, but it looks like it's number 8 for Chinese Taipei. Sung Hin Yu, is it? Japan. I can't just see now.
Number eight. Maybe I should look at my sheet. Yeah. Sung Ying Yu. Pan. Back to the captain.
Shot
big shot.
Murdo Pussy ducked out of the way of that one. It was coming like a bullet.
I can't believe how full the stands are, like, to my right.
People are getting ready. They know.
Yeah, but they still have to leave again and then come back in again.
Oh.
But it's good. It's nice to see them watching this game.
And it's a good
game. Big hit. Beautiful. But it's going to be a boarding call, I'm pretty sure. Either that or an elbow. So Chinese Taipei on the advantage. Goalie's pulling, getting off so they can get an advantage player
shot
on.
Shot comes in. And it's in.
Saved. It's saved. Under the bum. He laid an egg.
It's good awareness of the rules, Nadine Sheffield, to know that when the advantage has been given, get rid of the goalkeeper, bring on the extra body, and see if we can force a goal.
So number 16 from Turkmenistan is getting an interference call, so it was a late hit. And that is for Arslan Nurev, number 16. So he'll sit for two. So another power play for Chinese Taipei.
Sang. Looking for the opportunity. I think Sang's the trigger man. He's looking for a way to get through.
Jeremy, where's your tie?
Oh, no, I couldn't wear my tie today.
Don't lie. You were supposed to wear it over the jersey.
I was, guys, I must tell you, just so, as we get to the end of this second period of play, I've had two ice hockey presentations this week. The one from the South African Ice Hockey Federation, where I received this magnificent jersey that I wear now, and my number 55 will of course be retired. No other international player will be able to wear this number. Oh, that plays for South Africa, I mean.
We'll see about that.
And then the IIHF chairman of this tournament, forget the man's surname, France.
Yeah.
He'll come back to me, I beg your pardon. Presented a most stunning, beautiful IIHF tie. I don't wear ties often, but I do wear them.
You haven't sent me the France Randall.
France Randall, absolutely.
He's from Germany. You never sent me a photo of your tie.
It's still in the box. That one is going to stay in the box until my next IIHF event. Or SAHF event. Winding it down, we're in 70 seconds left on this second period of play. It's been a bit of a bounce back for Chinese Taipei. I guess, you know, in sports and in ice hockey, you make your own luck. And that's exactly what Chinese Taipei did. They made their own luck. All of the pressure coming from Turkmenistan, all of the go forward coming from Turkmenistan, but it was Chinese Taipei who were able to secure a 2-0 edge as we head now to the end of a very eventful, very exciting second period of play. And the gold medal, if it was alive, would be winking at the Chinese Taipei players. This is, there's for the taking, stolen. Bit of a miscue here from Turkmenistan.
Oh.
Not able to control. Would have been an interesting opportunity in terms of a shot and goal and maybe a third goal for Chinese Taipei. But it's Turkmenistan. They still have it.
10 seconds left. Turkmenistan clearing it out their zone. Dumped in and going for icing.
That's going
all the way back to Chinese Taipei. So there's 3 seconds left. If they can win a quick face-off and get a huge shot, they could get a goal. But it has to be, like, super quick.
So I'm interested in that kind of a tactic. It makes no sense for me, under no pressure, with 5-on-5, that you would do that and shoot one into the corner and it goes for icing and you've got a face-off deep inside your half.
They probably didn't realize the clock was going
to
be still on. And, oh, they tried it. They tried it, but it didn't
get exactly what you said.
Very close. Well done to them for trying. So Turkmenistan are going to go into the change room, and they're going to have a hell of a powwow, and they're going to come back, and they're going to fight hard. I'm pretty sure of it. But Chinese Taipei are also going to get a bit of a, hey, guys, there's only two. Why? You know? But well done for their two goals, because they were super quick. Concession, what did you say, 30 seconds?
Yeah, 33 seconds between goals. And certainly it turned the complexion of this game. It at that stage had been a lot of pressure, a lot of questions being asked by Turkmenistan, and Chinese Taipei doing their very best to be able to answer it. All of a sudden, bang, bang, two goals in no time at all, and things look a whole lot different.
Yeah, 27 shots to 24. They haven't updated the count on the scoreboard, you see, but on our stat sheet, 27-4, and that's Chinese Taipei with a 27. So it's it's definitely going more their way. They're getting a hell of a lot more shots on than Turkmenistan. But yeah, I don't think they're going to just take it lying down. Turkmenistan are going to really come and like fight hard for this. They want it just as bad.
Exactly, I agree with you. I think that Turkmenistan certainly came prepared. They were well aware of what is at stake, and that is just maybe the lift in the intensity that we saw. And when those two goals came in so quickly after each other, I think that probably just a natural reaction for Turkmenistan to feel a little bit sort of deflated. They're going to go and get themselves reinflated for the third and final period. Two goals is nothing in terms of getting that back. 20 minutes is a long time, and a gold medal is a massive motivator. So let's see what we see in a few minutes as we get ourselves ready for that third period.
Yeah, I'm going to do the shout out to all our sponsors at the end of this period. Great game of hockey here in South Africa, a great tournament we've had. City of Cape Town, Factor 6, CFW Fans, DigiCape, Sun Grand West, Sascock, Aquila, The Ice Station, Bloberg Mead, Western Cape Government, Ag Market, South African Ice Hockey Federation, Heart FM, Western Province Ice Hockey Association, Peninsula Beverages, that's Coca-Cola, Red Mountain, Pedigree Media, Department of Sports, Arts and Culture, Intro, Graphic Thought Design Company, Umgalula Africa, Computec, and a double IHF. So guys, we'll see you in about 13 minutes. There's going to be some highlights from the second period showing on your screen. Enjoy. Cheers for now.
Folks, 3 minutes and some change before the teams come out. I can see Chinese Taipei queuing to get onto the ice, and of course Turkmenistan will come out of their change rooms very shortly. I've seen also the South African players arrive, and the referees will get out onto the ice very shortly. Why don't you have a look at this standings again? You'll see that Taipei have got a plus 24 goal difference, Turkmenistan a plus 3 goal difference, and if it stays exactly like this, firstly, Taipei, Chinese Taipei will go to 12 points and they'll go to a plus 26 goal point. Turkmenistan will go to plus 1. That'll be minus 2 goals. They will lose 2 goals. The fact that they will lose potentially 2-0. Yeah. As I say, if it stays exactly like it is at the moment. And then it will get very crowded in the 6-point band because South Africa, if South Africa win, and it's a lot of ifs here. I'm just throwing out scenarios here, folks. I'm not saying anything. But if South Africa wins, South Africa also goes to 6 points.
Yes.
And then, as you say, Nadine Sheffield, then it's to look to see who is needing to be in a better
goal difference
scenario. We've got those scenarios.
And it's very complicated.
I use two.
The best thing
I use two calculators.
Is you should have had an interview with Jonathan Berger now. I told him to come and tell you how to deal with it.
I am going to have an interview with Jonathan Berger after this game. He just doesn't know it.
Well, there you go.
You'll see the South Africans, some of the South African players, Ryan Boyd on the right-hand side of your screen, standing there. He's waiting for his game to get underway. Turkmenistan coming out onto the ice.
So, I think that's Dylan O'Skierman. If not, it's one of the Fenter brothers. I can't see from this distance. But anyway, if Turkmenistan did take this game, right, then it would change the whole scenario, because Turkmenistan, Thailand and RSA would then go into their own little pool, and then it would all be sorted out by, because they would all be in six. And that's if South Africa also won the next game. So if South Africa won and Turkmenistan won, then it would be down to the goals against each other.
Turkmenistan already got two wins. They need to lose this game. They can't win this game.
Okay, then, no. True. You see, this is why Jonathan should be here. He's the results manager. I'm just the referee.
Tinsel says, if Luxembourg beats South Africa in regulation, South Africa will be relegated. Yes, correct.
Oh, and that's another question. We don't know if they're getting relegated because of North Korea pulling out. We think North Korea is getting relegated and somebody might stay here. I'll get that confirmation again. Okay, and we have a strong start here from Chinese Taipei. They've dumped it onto the net already. Turkmenistan with it now, setting it up, looking to get it a breakout. Straight through the middle. Good chance here, but Chinese Taipei putting the pressure on straight away. Stealing it away. Let's see here. Turkmenistan getting it back through the neutral zone. Looking for the outlet, but he's got some speed, so he's going to go through. Dumps it down. Cleared out. Ooh.
Okay, that wasn't supposed to happen.
No.
I mean, not to be overly dramatic, Nadine Sheffield, because you know me, I'm not overly dramatic sometimes. but this is 20 of the most important minutes for these two teams, and particularly Turkmenistan, that they will have in a long while. 20 minutes is what they will have to just fight through the pain, the exhaustion barrier, whatever it is that you want to call it.
Everything.
Somebody is going to have to make a mental decision of how important a gold medal is. Somebody in one of these two teams, and maybe it's a few somebodies, will need to make that decision, because that person and those other persons will then get that gold medal.
Yeah, it'll be up to the goal scorers, but also up to the goalkeepers.
Here we go, Turkmenistan.
Oh, tried to do a nice fake there, but...
and a great effort there. 16 for Turkmenistan in place. Aslan Nuriyev just not able to get it into the goals. Still, it's the all-green of Turkmenistan on the attack.
You know,
shuffled
who I
away.
Haven't seen today?
Yeah.
Is how did we get here?
That's a good point.
Tinsel fans back. Hi, Tinsel fans. But Tinsel I don't know fan. Where, how did we get here? He's probably sleeping. Because usually he's on every game. Never misses
he
it.
He might think that it's a 4 o'clock start.
Well, I hope not.
He might think it's 4 o'clock.
He's on the ball.
Yeah, he's normally quite organized. Yeah, he's definitely not in the... in the crowd, as it were.
That was so close.
He's probably going to come along going, what happened? The game is over, pal.
I see that the South African team has arrived. Obviously, we saw them earlier, and I see the coaching staff sitting on to my left. My right. You see, I don't know my left and my right. I still need tattoos of that. My right, they're sitting there watching the game a bit as well.
I see them, yes.
Luxembourg have arrived all in their suits and ties. Very smart, watching from the glass down below. As these two teams take on this gold medal game, quite literally.
And Nadine loves these guys who are so well dressed.
Oh, stick's broken. Somebody broke their stick.
Pieces of stick all over the ice. What does a hockey stick cost in South African rand?
A lot. They can be up to a good couple of grand, like from 1,000 to 3,000, depending.
But I mean like a really good top of the... of the.
Then you're going to pay a couple of like...
Like how much?
Thousands.
10,000?
No, not that much.
5,000.
Yeah, I'll show you. We can work it out for you.
Just give us a US dollar equivalent.
That's exactly what I'm about to do.
You and I are in sync. You see, I finish your...
sentences. Sorry.
Oh, wow.
It took me long enough. I'm busy concentrating.
Goodness me.
Give me a break.
The red light went on there as if the goal had been scored.
It wasn't me. Then the goal... Oh.
The red light went on. Nobody obviously picked it up, but I promise you the red light was on. I was about to scream goal, but then I realized that the puck was still being played up the boards. That was an interesting little mistake. Shot comes across the face of goal.
Okay, here we go. So, some sticks.
Shin. Back to Shin. Shot comes in. No, and there it is.
Oh, good save. But
save there.
Just
made it off.
Get a $340 US.
Here we go. That's the Luxembourg players, of course, as Nadine Sheffield was saying, in their suits and ties.
6,000 rand.
6,145 rand and a few cents.
For a $330 stick.
That is now smashed in pieces on the ice.
All depends on the sticks they have.
Oh, he didn't really have all of it. But it's still Turkmenistan who are able to clear their lines. Pressure coming from Chinese Taipei. Turkmenistan up the ice, up the boards, looking for a way through. All over Wachowski, but no real issue there. The officials watching it and going, that's fine. As Turkmenistan have it now. Long range effort, bobbles free. It's Miridov who's able to keep his lines clear.
There's something very wrong here. Whew. I wonder if Turkmenistan are going to get some back. We've got a penalty.
Gibanov is in the cinnamon.
Short-handed.
It's the captain, Ekmet Gibanov. He's going to sit for 2 minutes. Now, what will Chinese Taipei do with this? They don't need to score any more goals. But, I mean, they can't help themselves. So, I mean, let's see what comes of it. Chinese Taipei looking for the way through. It's the 10. It's the shot. It's behind the goals.
Up from the point, we have number 4 with it. Is he going to take it through? No, he passes it. Quick shot. Great save there by Miridov.
Saw that coming. Here comes the shot. Long range effort.
Ooh,
off the goalposts. I think it was off the crossbar. That was just 2 centimeters too high. There we go. Gibanov in the sin bin. He'll be there for another 1 minute and 16 seconds. As Chinese Taipei come away with it. Pan up the ice all on his own. And the offload behind the Turkmenistan goals now. The setup. 15. Pan has it. Somebody's left their stick behind.
So, Jeremy, if you were to be playing goalie,
yes,
your stick would cost you about 3,600 rand.
2,600
3,600
rand. Every time I talk to you, it gets more expensive.
3,600
rand.
Isn't that a normal thing for a woman?
Okay, here we go. And Pan had all of the body shape to take the shot, decided not to. Skids it around the back. Get the sense of just playing a waiting game, waiting, and misdirected shot. A good build-up there, but not able to get it on target as it gets sent down the ice. No icing, of course. Still 10 seconds left on this power play. Nothing's going to come from it, I don't believe. It's been well handled by Turkmenistan.
Yeah, they've done a great job.
Their skipper, Gibanov, will make his way back out onto the ice. Straight away into it, Gibanov steps off the sit bin. Wow.
Almost kills his own goalie. Does win.
I mean, we saw that when the Chinese Taipei's first goal, Gibanov almost returned the favor as he stepped literally out of the sin bin, almost onto the puck.
Time is ticking down. 12 minutes left. Oh, and a
shot to come.
Saved and rebound, but cleared away.
Miradov just on point there. Here come Turkmenistan. Still a chance for them. They've got time. They've got the position on the ice, but not able to score the goal. 11 minutes and 50 seconds left of this third and final period. It's Chinese Taipei with a somewhat fortuitous 2-0 lead.
Turkmenistan have been doing an outstanding job, in my opinion.
Absolutely.
They're holding it down there on the boards and it goes down, but it's clear. Lots of screaming going on. Great save there.
Not too sure where that went, and neither was Tsao, as it went over him, over the goalposts.
Lots of pushing and shoving and moving and shouting and ref shouting and irritation, retaliation. Here we go. There's going to be a penalty on number 6. Krakowski. What is he getting it for there?
Pavel Borowski, I beg your pardon. Krakowski. Krakowski, you're quite right.
2 minutes for interference.
Interference?
Probably a late hit again. Didn't see it though.
Let's see. I mean, it was...
I still didn't see it though, but anyway. Wait. Let's see what happens.
From one power play situation to another, literally minutes apart. Not exactly the kind of position that Turkmenistan want to be in. Here we go, Pavel Borkowski inside that that Sinbin. He's here, also looked very nice to me as well, Nadine. Shot to come, bubbles free. And saved.
Great work there by Muradov.
Let's have a look at it. You can see this build up coming up shortly. Goes up down the boards. Here we go. It's Shen. And in it comes.
Nice, I think, pass to win.
What I like is he got rid of it early on. Didn't take it all the way to the line.
Great shot there again. They're firing accurately nicely now. But they found the net. Chance here for Turkmenistan. Bit of a fumble.
Turkmenistan short-handed, but they're at the moment applying the pressure. They are getting in there.
It's loose.
Good double save there.
Oh, check the referee jumping on the net to try and
fancy
get out the way.
Fancy footwork there from Italian referee Andrea Benvegnu.
I've seen that in a few NHL games when the puck's like trying to there and he's... Yeah, but that was cool.
It's like he was tap dancing. I mean, I was describing the one referee as a figure skater, now a tap dancer. And if he comes to me after the game like that other referee did and tells me that he actually is a tap dancer, then that will be the end of it.
Then you're going to be a prophet.
Yeah.
Prophet Jeremy. You
can pick them.
You can predict the future. Predict these people's past.
In comes the shot.
Lives.
Surely no. The setup. More important to Chinese Taipei. Looking for good position. Still. No trigger. Looking for the quick sort of half
deflection,
touch
yeah.
on it. Not able, but still, it's Chinese Taipei. They're going to offload it to Sang, surely. Great position. There we go. Sang has it now.
But he's looking for his point, man. Number 10's a bit low down now.
Yeah, I would push him more up to the middle of the ice.
And rather walk it in, yeah. Oh, it's loose and he's got a chance.
Oh great. Went just wide. Just got a stick on it. I think that he was on target, but it was a stick on it from Turkmenistan.
That's good. And another shot chance.
To come.
And it's loose.
It's loose. And
it's gone. But now the goalie's waving his hand. I'm not sure why.
I think he kicked it in.
If he did, we can see on the replay, he's definitely saying it was a kick. So I'm thinking the refs might have a barcode meeting, yes.
Everybody's coming over.
They're going to have a barcode meeting, see if anybody saw the kick.
The body position of the Chinese Taipei player suggests that he kicked it in. Here comes the replay, let's have a look.
Please bear in mind, the referees don't get to see this.
There we go. And his foot, his back foot, because he had his back to
his
the goal.
His back foot was the one that pushed it in, but I don't
it in.
Think
here
it was
this is
going to
give us a great position. Here we go, and it's
no,
definitely...
No, that is so a kick, but...
Definitely the foot.
It kind of could have been intentional, but couldn't have been. From this angle, it looks like it was intentional.
Turkmenistan are just
they
protesting...
Are but they don't get to use the replay option. That is not available to referees or teams in this division. Only we as spectators have this option. It's up to what the ref sees on the ice. So now the referee has called it a goal.
Got to tell you, it is just a death blow to Turkmenistan. That is the end of it. I can tell you now, they are never going to come back from this 3-0 deficit, and particularly after that kind of a goal. It's been the way that the game has gone. It's just been good fortune that has gone Chinese Taipei's way. A definite foot in for that third goal. But as Nadine Sheffield says, the officials here don't get to see the replay. They would maybe have been unsighted. Well, they would definitely have had to have been unsighted. Because we can tell you for certain that it definitely was a goal scored by the foot.
Yeah. You know, if it's deflected in, it's not a problem. But if there's any movement of a skate going towards the net or angling it actually to get it in, that is now considered a no goal. So that was very deliberate movement towards the goal, from what our point of view could see, but it could not have been seen by the referee, as he also was on just the opposite side of the net and the goalie would have possibly been in his direct line of sight to see how the puck was pushed in. But he did have a conference with his two linesmen and they all discussed it, and that was how they decided. Now there's a slashing penalty coming here for Turkmenistan. Seems like it's heating up quite a lot now between these two teams, but he is going in for a slash, and that's number 17 from Turkmenistan. The Genç Dolomitrov. So that goal was scored by Hung Lee Chow, number 12, and Cho In Sang, number 4, got the assist.
I don't understand that. It's a goal. He was pushed back and wasn't looking at the puck. So if
you
don't have the intent...
So they're saying it was accidental and he didn't know that the puck was there, if it's very possible. But you also could act unbeknownst that I didn't know the puck was there, but you know the puck.
I mean, if he had scored it intentionally,
yeah,
that would be the most magnificent display of skill and coordination, because he was falling.
He was going backwards.
And he wasn't even looking. I don't think he knew where the puck was.
So that's, I think, also what the referees would have discussed and what they would have seen. And that's why they make the decision how they did.
Oh, sniper.
Again?
Yeah.
So Brandon Sau, watching on our live stream, and he's related to the goalie Sau in the net at the moment, is saying that Chinese Taipei is about to follow their under 18 and under 20 teams to advance from divisions 3A to 2B for the first time in the country's history since we joined the IIHF program back in 2008.
That's amazing. That's a great story. I like it.
Very, very cool. But a nice world of firsts for them. And it's 3-0. So...
No, Brandon, I can tell you now, Paul, this is done. There's no way that I can see Turkmenistan coming back from that. Firstly, there's 6.5 minutes left. Turkmenistan are going to need to score 4 goals in 6.5 minutes. That I don't believe is possible. And also, I just don't think that Chinese Taipei will allow them. Sau is not going to allow that. There's no way you score past him easily on any given Friday. Or what is today?
Sunday.
That's just a movie, by the way.
Ooh, I remember.
Yeah. Here we go. It's Pan. He will take his time. He can take lots of time. Here we go. It's Chinese Taipei, though, up the ice.
Look at the speed.
Just lovely to watch.
Oh, beautifully clear. He's out all the time in the world.
Gliding. It's like he's gliding on the ice. Just not even touching the ice. Here we go. Shot to come. Trigger man.
Turkmenistan with a chance. He's looking for help, but there's no one there. Shut down well there by the defenseman. And that's an icing call for Chinese Taipei. Our load shedding. So everybody, just so you know, we are going to have a blackout again in the next 5 minutes or so.
Oh, this game will be over. And there we go. It's a great effort, a great shot there from Turkmenistan, almost getting through Tsao, using his knee to get rid of it. Shot comes in and took a big paw. It's like a big bear paw that Rahman Miradov has got it.
Nine. Oh, he lost his stick. Let's see it. Wen gets a big hit. Oh, and heads collide and sticks go flying. That was very hectic, actually. I don't know if this guy's now sore because he fell off the bench or if that
only his head.
Him so hitting the other guy's head. Because when he checked the Wen, their heads collided together.
Should maybe try to get to see that again. There's obviously concern for the player. Keen to see the bump on it, the knock and contact on this. Here we go.
They both collided and he hit their heads. They're both their heads.
Sticks are flying.
Hit each other like face to face.
And immediately it's...
But again, it was initiated by the Turkmenistan player, so he should actually get a checking to the head.
He may very
but
well still
again, the referees don't see our replays, so we just can see it. It looked painful for both of them. But they don't get to see what we see.
The officials are sort of hanging about there to see what's going to be the next
thing.
So
we've got somebody coming to sit in the box. So number 15 is going to sit.
Oh, that's an interesting decision. I mean, what did he do?
Bejaviev. See the call quite exactly from the ref. I was too busy watching the replays.
Bejaviev.
Oh, look at the Thailand fans. Was it Chinese Taipei? No, it's Thailand.
Thailand. Chinese Taipei with 5.5 minutes left on the third period. 5.5 minutes left on the game. 3-0, the advantage. They are not going to be beaten. They're not going to be prevented of coming away with a really good and a 100% record out of this particular tournament and the gold medal as well. This will certainly be foremost in their thoughts as they get themselves, they wind down the few minutes that remain.
By the way, that penalty was for interference.
Nadine, you must get the arena to please sell t-shirts and say, I love load shedding. It'll be the only place you can buy it, because I'm sure nobody else will have a t-shirt that says that.
Oh, you guys are funny. Right, 4:44 left on the clock. 3-0. 32 shots to, well, actually 41 shots to 28, according to my shot count. It has to be updated still. 1 minute left for this penalty kill for Turkmenistan. Whether or not Chinese Taipei are going to put another one in the box or not, who knows? We'll soon see. Turkmenistan doing okay with their penalty kill. Faceoff's going to actually be outside the zone. Here we go. One back by Turkmenistan. Up and through the neutral zone. We got a chance.
Good.
Just gets loose.
Just gets the stick.
They've tried. They've kept trying the whole way through. You've got to give it to Turkmenistan. They really have put in such a great effort this game.
Absolutely. A wonderful shift as we get ourselves to the last 4 minutes of the game. It's Pan looking for a way through. Offloads it to Lin now. It's skidded off. Remember, of course, we're in a power play. So here we go. There's the South Africans. Not all of them, obviously, but most of the South African team getting ready their game at 6 o'clock this evening, South African time. That's local time, which is about 2 hours from now. So that game will get underway then against Luxembourg for the South Africans. Also a must-win scenario. They need to come away with a win. And I think if my maths serves me, they're going to have to come away with a big win.
A very big win, yeah. Check out this shot. It's actually quite a beautiful one and a great save by Miradov. Beautiful shot, accurate. Went through and just kept in there.
Miradov is very funny.
I'm just reading Tinsel fans' comments saying, yeah. Yeah, if a player commits an infraction and they're injured, can another player take their place in the box? I mean, imagine putting a Luxembourg player in the penalty box, for example, if he had fouled. So, yes, another player would take it as a bench penalty, but I can tell you right now, if that player were to get back on the ice, there would be a big problem. However, you can see, well, I can see that the player that did have the infraction is actually getting tended to medically on the bench. When their heads collided, he has been injured. So, he has to have the penalty sat by somebody else. Five on five, last 3.5 minutes of the game. You're going to see lots of celebration coming, I'm very sure, from the Chinese Taipei team. In the next few minutes, and I'm sure Sao is really hoping to have a shutout here, and I think he could do it. Been a very good game to watch. These two teams have been very evenly matched the whole way through, except for now, obviously. Oh, he tripped over the goalie. He's a bit stuck there. Backwards trip, so it's just a goal crease infraction. He's not going to get a penalty for it. They just blew the whistle because the goalie was impeded. So, yeah, nothing too hectic.
Let's have a look at this. See him coming in backwards, backwards.
And I think he just misjudged it. The goalie kind of also looks like he looked, stuck his leg out and said, hey, trip you.
And then they were almost stuck together for a bit.
It was unintentional, that. Well, from the Turkmenistan side, that is.
Oh, well, I was giving them too much benefit of the doubt, as called earlier by Nadine Sheffield. A few minutes later, we have a power outage. 3 minutes and 10 seconds left on the game clock for this particular game. Effectively, it is our gold medal match. Either of these teams win it, they would have claimed the gold medal. Chinese Taipei very much looking like they will walk away winners here, courtesy of their 3-0 advantage.
I've lost my Wi-Fi. Turkmenistan still getting possession. Here they come away.
Oh, good skill pass. Almost the whole way.
Just couldn't get back on it. But
and also another opportunity, but just behind the player. Oh, off the poles.
Ooh, and another shot, but kept well there by Miradov.
That was off the upright. At this replay, you'll see the shot comes in. It didn't look like, you know, the strongest shot we've ever seen. It was bobbling around, but it hits the upright. 12 also has a good go, but shoots it straight into
Miradov. Oh, the goalie has having an equipment malfunction.
Number 24, Lynn's going to miss most of the rest of the game. He's in the sin bin.
Oh, I didn't even see that. 2 minutes for slashing. Interesting. He's even confused.
Yeah, he is going, what on earth? How did that happen?
I have 9 seconds left to play the game.
Lin, 9 seconds. He is...
A lot can happen in 9 seconds. You saw what happened last time. The guy got on and went and scored. So, except his penalty box not so close this time.
He was sent for slashing. Shot comes in and off the post. Tell you what, they are still trying on Turkmenistan. 2 minutes left on it.
You know, I'm such a chop. I was trying to ask my results manager if the relegation, do we know if it's DPR Korea or the guys here? And I actually sent it to my partner. And he's like, what? Oh, gosh. No wonder I'm not getting answers.
Yeah, well, all of the questions you guys have been asking... Nadine,
I'm just going to tell him wrong husband.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so funny. Last minute and a half left here, and the scramble is definitely on. Turkmenistan desperately trying to get one on the board.
And I can tell you that the Chinese Taipei player who is in the sin bin, it's number 24, Joo-Hyo Lin, is still not sitting down. He can't believe that he's been sent to the bin. Here we go. There's he on screen at the moment. He's almost like he's counting. He's like almost talking his way through it. He was completely confused when they sent him. He's like, what on earth? Normally by now they're seated over the top of the goals. Turkmenistan trying for all they're worth. They've got an opportunity with an extra man on the ice and hoping to at least get a consolation goal, if nothing else. Because they realize that their goal difference now becomes zero. They had a +3 goal difference. Now it's gone. So it's naught now.
Mm.
And that makes for a very interesting... I mean, a goal now makes for a very interesting next sort of set of permutations. 19 seconds.
They managed to keep it in.
Lin is standing good and ready to go. There was an opportunity there. That would have made a difference. Bodies on the line. Turkmenistan
big
applying
hit.
The
referee sniped.
The referee even got sniped.
And
there
a goal!
Is.
They've done it! Turkmenistan have managed to put one away. Number 6 gets that one. They finally put one on the board.
They finally got Partsal. How many goals have they scored?
Pavel Barkovsky. Putting it in away. I think, no, wait, it could be number 8. I think it might have been number 8.
Here it comes. And in.
Yeah, it's Akinyazov.
They made that extra man count.
Look at this replay from the back end.
Great pass here through the legs of the Chinese Taipei player and then into the net.
Sao, of course, obviously Chinese Taipei is super excited. They know they've just got gold, even though the goal was scored. There's 3.9 seconds left. They're already congratulating each other. Super excited. Jeremy's just leaving me. But he's got a job to do down on the ice, and that's it. That is it. Chinese Taipei have taken the gold medal for the South African, for Cape Town World Championship here. Look at the excitement on that team. Well deserved. But you know what? Turkmenistan gave them a very big run for their money. They did a great job of holding them off and getting that last goal in the last few seconds. Well deserved. Congratulations to both teams. Wow. Chinese Taipei setting records here for them. Up to the next division. So guys, I'm just going to have my quick shout out here to the sponsors so that I can hand over to Jeremy for this event where they give out the players awards and the best player for the two teams on the ice. City of Cape Town, Factor 6, CFW Fans, Sun Grand West, DigiCape, Sass Clock, Aquila, The Ice Station, Bloberg Meek, Western Cape Government, Ag Market, South African Ice Hockey Federation, Heart FM, Western Province Ice Hockey Association, Coca-Cola Peninsula Beverages, Red Mountain, Pedigree Media, Department of Sports, Arts and Culture, Intro, Graphic Thought Design, Umgalelo Africa, Computic and a Double IHF. So guys, from me, please join us shortly at 6 o'clock. That is when the South Africans are going to face off against Luxembourg. And we hope to have you here in your presence in South Africa. If you're in Cape Town, come and watch in the stands. The crowd's going to be packed. But otherwise, please join us live on the feed and enjoy and support your fellow Team South African playmates. Well, teammates, sorry. Terrible. I'm terrible. I'm going to say goodnight. Bye for now.
Ladies and gentlemen, both goals at the end of the matchup. The final score stands to a Turkmenistan on one goal and Chinese Taipei
on three goals. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, handing out the best player awards for this matchup, we have the South African representative for Western Province Ice Hockey, Sharif Kamish, and the president of the South African Ice Hockey Federation, Jason Cerf. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the best player for this matchup for Turkmenistan goes to player number 8. That's Amangaldi Aganiazov. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and the best player for this matchup for the winning team this afternoon for the Chinese Taipei goes to player number 15, Ying Chen Pan. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, now for the special awards for best player of the tournament for each team. These awards will be handed out by a man whose hair might be gray, but he's a heart of bronze. Ladies and gentlemen, the IIHF, that's the International Ice Hockey Federation tournament chairperson, Franz Reindl. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and the player of the tournament for Turkmenistan goes to play number 10. That's Arslan Gemeryadov. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and now for the best player of the tournament, for the Chinese Taipei, that goes to player number 19, the assistant captain, Hung Yu Lin. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we now ask everyone to please rise as we play the national anthem for the winning team of this matchup, the Chinese Taipei. Once again, a very good congratulations to the Chinese Taipei for winning this matchup. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, also a special congratulations to those who have received these special awards for player of the tournament for each team who have both received a watch sponsored by Tissot. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we will now be shortly taking a break before we start the next countdown, starting at 5 p.m. in which we will begin this 60-minute countdown before the final matchup this evening taking place at 6 p.m. between South Africa and Luxembourg in the final matchup of the International Ice Hockey Federation 2023 World Championship in the division.
Well, there we go, folks. That's the end of what turned out to be the gold medal match. The match between Chinese Taipei and Ministan eventually won by Chinese Taipei 3-1. At one stage, it did look like Turkmenistan would present something of an upset. Certainly, the four books suggested and the pundits suggested that it would be a Chinese Taipei win. That's eventually what we got to. But in the early part of the game, it was a really intense battle from Turkmenistan. They really did put their best foot forward. Lots of very attractive ice hockey to look forward to that they presented here as well. So 3-1 the win there, and lots of emotion, lots of celebration, particularly from Chinese Taipei as they come away with effectively the gold in this one. Big game, of course, coming up this evening at 6 o'clock local time as South Africa are in action against Luxembourg. We've got some time before we get there. We've got some highlights, particular encounter. Let's take a look at those highlights now. Folks, so of course, the question is what is on the cards in terms of the permutations that exist for the final game. South Africa against Luxembourg. I'm joined by LOC member for results and statistics for this particular tournament, Jonathan Berger, of course, referee-in-chief for Western Province Ice Hockey. So we've seen the result now, 3-1 to Chinese Taipei over Turkmenistan. Essentially, it was the gold medal match because either of those teams could have, with a win, taken the gold medal. What has to happen in this second game in terms of who takes the silver and the bronze?
So it's quite an interesting one because now Turkmenistan still stay on 6 points. South Africa have to win. That's the main deal so that they can go into 6 points. Basically what happens is we'll take Turkmenistan, Thailand and South Africa out, make a little table between them. Issue there, it became a bit complicated because now they've both won one, both won two, both lost two, and the goal difference is zero for all three of them. So then we went to who scored the most goals. And out of that, it would be Turkmenistan, South Africa second, and Thailand third. So essentially, if we win tonight, we win the bronze medal. That's pretty much as where it stands.
So a scenario suggests that, as you say, there's no other objective for South Africa other than to win. They've got to do that if they stand any chance of a medal.
100%. They need the 3 points. Turkmenistan have pretty much secured silver medal with this loss pretty much because they've obviously scored, I think it was 12 goals. We're sitting on 11. And so we have to win. If we don't, we obviously stay on 3 points and then it would be Turkmenistan and then Thailand.
Here we go, folks. That's the upshot of it all. It's down to South Africa, and I suppose exactly what the team will appreciate, that they need to do, and I say all they need to do, is come away with the 3 points. All they've got to do is get past Luxembourg in the final game, and they may very well be able to count on and claim that bronze medal. Time will tell. 6 o'clock is when that one gets underway local time, so looking forward once again to your company from all around the world. Thanks very much. We'll see you later.